I'm sure it's no surprise to anyone that Akira is one of my favorite anime movies and one of my favorite movie in generals. And if you've actually looked at some of my content before, you probably would know that. But did you guys know that there were two dubs to Akira? Yeah, there was the Streamline Pictures dub from the original 1988 version, and there's the 2001 version. And I'm sure you have seen my older dub battle video. I didn't really go into detail on that, so I took it off. But my love for Akira is one of the biggest things that makes me an anime fan. I am an avid anime freaking fan, and Akira was one of the biggest reasons of what bred me my love. I am so huge on Akira that I have had both versions of Tetsuo on the show. Jan Rapson from the 89 version and Joshua Seth. And then on top of that, you know, to add more on top of it, well, I also had Jerry Beck, one of the co-founders of Streamline Pictures. So, well, let's talk about this. Let's get things started and let's do it. Let's start this anime dub battle.
Roar of the winning punch.
Okay, I suppose we'll start with the main character of, well, he's not the exact main character. The title main character should be the main character. This is confusing. We're going to start out with Kaneda. And he is on the actual cover, even though he's not really in the movie all that much. Anyhow, let's start out with the 89 version of Akira. Let's listen to Cam Clark's version of Kaneda, shall we? Let's listen.
Don't make me laugh. Maybe when you downed your first clown.
What happened? Quite a mess. Quite a scare into all of us. The guys thought you might be out here crying for help again.
Okay, let's settle this once and for all.
Man, I don't know what it is about Cam's voice, but he just has a very likable performance to it. And he makes it sound so cocky, yet so cool at the same time. But I'm not gonna lie, it sounds like I'm listening to a Ninja Turtle here. Okay, well, let's listen to Johnny Young Bosch's version of this, shall we?
If you want it so bad, then steal one yourself!
What's wrong? Have some trouble? Tetsuo, you had me worried again. I figured you'd be standing here sobbing like a little baby. Mr. Kaneda, you punk!
And both are great. I know one is a Power Ranger and one is a Ninja freaking Turtle. But when it comes down to it, and as much as I hate to say this, Johnny sounds kind of, well, bland. I don't know if it's because he's not really emotionally invested in it and this is one of his early projects, but he just sounds really bland. Cam seems to come off with a lot more personality, and I know that's really, really heartbreaking to hear, but that's just what I'm hearing. Cam is the clear winner here. So, sorry, Johnny fans. This role is not for me. We're on to my favorite character of the movie, Tetsuo Shima. Tetsuo is a badass, and he happens to be portrayed by, in this round, Jan Rapson in the 1989 version and Joshua Seth in the 2001 version. So, since we're gonna go by dates first, let's listen to Jan Rapson's version first, shall we? Let's hit it.
You got it! I'm gonna wipe this guy all over the street!
I wish you'd just go away and leave me alone.
What?
You think I'm a loser! It's not my fault I was smaller! Well, there'll come a day when I'll show all of you!
This is more than Chemistry 101, man. I'm not back in school anymore. Ever since I was a kid, you've been telling me what to do, always treating me like a kid.
Something about Jan's voice really makes Tetsuo at the beginning sound a little off at first, but when he gets into his anger and rage scenes, man, he sounds freaking menacing. As much as I just love this performance, he does great, and he makes Tetsuo so awesome. But enough gushing about Jan, let's listen to Joshua Seth's version, shall we?
Why do you always have to try to save me? I could handle it on my own. Yeah, I admit, I've gotten beaten before, but I won't always be on the receiving end. You hear that? You've always been a pain in the ass, you know. You've been telling me what to do since we were kids. You always treat me like a kid. You always show up and start bossing me around, and don't you deny it.
Josh does an equally as good job as Jan. I mean, he can make his voice sound menacing, and at the beginning you actually can buy that Tetsuo is kind of a wuss here. He's a wussy that gets beaten up and gets kicked around, he gets bullied. You can really buy that in the performance of his voice. But when it comes to him being menacing, he kind of falls flat. See, if it were me, I would take both performances and mash them up together. That's how good both of them are. Normally in a dub battle, it's one or the other for me. But I like menacing Tetsuo more than I like good wimpy Tetsuo. And that's just my opinion. So the winner is going to be Jan Rabson here. And yeah, maybe that I'm biased and I'm living in nostalgia, but that's just my choice. Don't forget that. Let's move on to the next character. Is the Espers, and I'm going to do something a little different now. I'm going to rank the three of them together because basically, well, you kind of just, you don't see them one without the other very many. I mean, Takashi shows up at the beginning without the other two, but, you know, shortly right behind the other two show up. So I'm just going to rank which versions of the voice I like the best. And by the way, on the second half, the other two voice actors apparently didn't go very far. They were just little kids, and they didn't get anywhere, really. So I guess they're not really prolific voice actors. Anyway, let's start out with the 1989 dub, considered to be one of the best ones. Let's listen to Takashi's and Kyoko's and Masaru's versions of their voices for the 1989 version. Let's go.
Get away!
Tetsuo!
Stop it! You're going to hurt someone if you don't stop.
You're going to tell me where Akira is.
You know it.
You won't be able to escape. Takashi! Once we approach, well, you know we won't have the power to return.
You know what is really good? Barbara Goodson sounds excellent. I think her voice fits perfectly, but she's been voicing young boys for years, so it's a really good fit. The other two, Bob Bergens is doing a Marlon Brando impersonation, and then finally the girl, she sounds probably actually really good in my book. Because, well, her voice kind of just fits an older, wiser lady trapped in a little kid's body. I kind of like that the voices sound older because it shows that their bodies are aging and their voices would age slowly. Well, all right, let's listen to the 01 version.
This Akira.
I won't tell.
West, there's no escape. We're here to take you back with us. You know we can't survive outside.
Well, surprisingly, the voices fit here too. But this is where I'm going to nitpick here. The 01 version, well, the kids' acting sounds really stilted. So I don't actually like it. I mean, you could tell that the two kids, except for Sandy Fox, of course, doesn't really have much experience, and you could just hear it in their voices. They sound really terrible. I rather listen to the Marlon Brando version of Masaru's voice than listen to those other kids. They sound awful. And yeah, that's a real major hit. The Streamline dub is in the lead right now, but the winning team right now is the 89 version. Let's go on. Is K. And I'm not going to do a whole bunch of characters, you know, like all of Kaneda's biker gang or all of the clowns and all of the military people. No, I'm just going to do the characters that have more screen time in the story. Next is K, actually. And K does a pretty decent job at playing the love interest, even though she looks like a female version of Kaneda. Anyhow, let's listen to Laura Cody's version, the 89 version first. Let's go.
You're still alive!
Kay!
Roy!
Are you sure he's all right?
Well, he's not a spy, that's for sure.
Now, she's not bad. She does give off a good vibe personality to Kay, and she kind of gets that whole smart-aleck response down. I like some of her lines like, what's it to you anyway, and stuff like that. They kind of modernize that. They put a lot of emotion into the streamlined version to Akira. Now, the next one in the 01 version, she's played by Wendy Lee. Let's take a listen to Wendy's version.
Oh, are you all right?
Kay, it's you.
Theo.
Well, is he a spy or not?
Whatever he is, he's certainly not a spy.
Surprisingly enough, honestly, I think Wendy actually wins this round. She does really good at giving Kay a lot more personality, and I really like Laura Cody's voice for Kay a lot. I mean, the streamlined dub is the one that I probably watch a lot, but when it comes to down to it, Wendy Lee has a good voice. It's kind of funny that Laura Cody and her would team up in another streamlined movie called the Dirty Pair series, which is fantastic. Okay, let's move on to the next character. This is going to be the last character for now, and it's going to be the Colonel. Now, why did I pick the Colonel out of all the other characters other than Yama or whoever to play as, like the scientist? The Colonel is actually the unsung hero of this movie, if you think about it. He has nothing but good intention. He wants to save the town, and he wants to make sure nobody gets killed, and he has to really risk his neck out and deal with shitty-ass politicians to do it. Now, let's listen to both versions of his voice. Let's start with the 89 version, Tony Pope.
Ha! A typical romantic. All you scientists are. We soldiers begin by considering the risk. It's taken all of 30 long years. We've progressed quite a way since that Holocaust, and we can't risk losing it all now because of this. The people lost their pride in our great achievement a long time ago. Ah. Now all these fools care about is indulging themselves.
Tony is fan-freaking-tastic. He really kind of makes him sound like Nappa. Like both versions of Nappa, Phil Parsons and the Ocean Dub version of Nappa. But he sounds good. Now the next one is going to be portrayed by Jameson Price. Now let's listen to Jameson's version, shall we?
Scientists are a bunch of romantics. Military men, on the other hand, always consider the risks first. Over 30 years it's taken. We've come so far crawling up from the rubble. We can't just trade one for the other. The passion to build is cooled, and the joy of reconstruction forgotten. Now is just a garbage heap made up of a bunch of hedonistic fools.
Jameson is a fantastic actor. He has great roles, and he is a terrific actor too. I love almost all his anime roles, but I don't like this one. I think his voice sounds way too deep for the character, and it's not like the same emotion. The Colonel showed genuine care for the kids. He showed genuine care for the city, even though he was hardened up. He was just that good. And I think Tony Pope's voice really kind of grabs that. It's excellent. It's fantastic, honestly. So the winner in this round is Tony Pope. And that means that the winning team for this is the streamlined dub to Akira. Now, that does end this dub battle, and I will admit that it was very biased in this video. It really wasn't a fair game, and a lot of the actors and etc. did really well here. I love it, and I can't pick between, two things. I'm not going to say that one dub is trashy and one dub is perfect. I live in nostalgia. That's one of my biggest fallbacks and one of my biggest issues. I live in freaking nostalgia. And Akira, I think the original streamlined dub was fine the way it was. Yeah, it had some name issues and etc., but there was effort and emotion put into it. And I think the performances we got from Jan Rabson and Cam Clark and several of the other people that I list was just really worth it. And it made Akira what it is today. An excellent perfection film. And honestly, I can never find an anime movie that can compete with Akira's amazingness. So the dub battle, Streamline Pictures is the winner here. But that doesn't mean that I dislike the other dub. I like it for what it was or what it tried to do. It tried to fix the problems of the old one. But for now, that's it for this dub battle. If there's another dub battle you guys want me to hit, let me know in the comments. Always remember, I'm listening.
Hi, this is Dorothy Fawn. Be sure to like and subscribe to Mr. Tim's YouTube channel. Yeah.